Hello, my dear friends. Welcome back to the channel. And this is your friend, Dr. Suresh Envy. From few days, few students have asked me to make a video on dental casting defects. And as a student, even I used to struggle with it. And various dental entrance exams also ask the questions from this topic very often. So let's understand it the super simplified way. But before doing that, let us be familiar with few terminologies in casting. When you want to make a cast restoration, first you have to make the wax pattern. And that wax pattern will be invested in a casting ring. And in that casting ring, we'll pour the investment material, and after the investment material sets, this casting ring is heated so that the wax burns out. That's why this procedure is called as wax burnout, and this gives you a mold in the investment material in which a heated metal is poured with some pressure, and once the metal sets, the investment is broken and you get the cast restoration, which will be finished and polished. Now, anything can go wrong during any of these steps and you may not have a good cast restoration, and that's why it is very important to learn about dental casting defects so that you can avoid this. Because if you have a dental casting defects, a smaller one may not create a problem, but if it is a bigger one, then you may have to recall the patient and do the impression again, and the whole lab procedure will be repeated. So how are the dental casting defects classified? Basically, the dental casting defects are classified into four categories. One is the distortion, second is the surface roughness or irregularities formed on the cast restoration, third being the porosity, which students really find very difficult to understand, and then there is incomplete casting or missing details. So let's talk about the first defect, that is the distortion. And distortion means that your final cast restoration doesn't match the tooth preparation what you have done for the cast restoration. And this depends on two factors, the first being the wax itself which you have used to make the pattern. If the wax pattern gets distorted, then your final cast restoration will also be distorted. The wax distorts because it has memory in it. And also, if you have subjected to various temperatures during the wax pattern, this also leads to some amount of stress buildup in the wax pattern. And if you have not invested this pattern very soon, this stress will be relieved and the wax will try to open up to its original position. And if you want to avoid this, you simply have to invest the wax pattern as soon as possible and also not subject the wax pattern to a lot of temperature changes. The second reason for wax distortion is because of the investment material in which the wax pattern is invested. As we all know that the metal used to make the cast restoration will shrink when it is cooling down, and in order to compensate this, we have to expand our mold. And during this expansion, the thin portion of wax pattern may not resist the expansion when compared to the thick portion, which will definitely resist the movement. Fortunately, this distortion is very minimal. Now let's talk about the second major category of the dental casting defect, and that's about surface roughness and irregularities. And what is the difference between the roughness and irregularities? As you can see in this image, a surface roughness is a generalized defect, whereas a surface irregularity is an isolated defect. And what is the problem of having a surface irregularity or the surface roughness? Since it is only a surface phenomenon, this is mostly related to the finishing and polishing, and having more surface roughness and irregularity means you will have to finish and polish the cast restoration bit more. So what are the causes for surface roughness? There are various causes, the first being the presence of air bubble, which may happen when you are pouring the investment material beside the wax pattern. And in order to avoid this type of surface roughness, it is better to always invest the wax pattern under the vacuum so that air bubbles do not form into the investment. The second reason being the presence of water film. As you know that the wax is hydrophobic, you may have some amount of water left between the wax pattern and the investment material. This forms some amount of irregularities on the cast restoration. This can be avoided by applying a wetting agent on the wax pattern before it is invested. The next reasons are related to the heating of the investment material, and it can be either rapid or prolonged heating. If you are heating the investment material rapidly, it can form the steam of water, or it can directly form a crack into the investment also, which may be connected to the mold. Similarly, the prolonged heating also can release the sulfur, which can form the irregularities, or even this can form the cracks in the investment material. And in order to prevent this, you have to make sure that if you are using gypsum board in investment material, which is generally heated till 700 degrees Celsius, then you have to reach this temperature from room temperature in approximate 60 minutes and not less than that. Similarly, the underheating of the casting also leads to the irregularities because it can form the wax residue, or the gases may also remain into the mold space, which will end up forming the irregularities. The next reason for surface irregularities is the temperature of alloy, or the pressure and the speed at which this metal is forced into the mold space. As you can see in this image, if the metal is flowing very fast, or if you are using a lot of pressure to force the metal into the mold, then this can hit the end of the wall and form the crack, which may lead to surface roughness in the cast restoration. The texture of the investment material will also affect. For example, if you have a rough investment material, then obviously the casting will also be rough in contrast to a smoother mix. The next reason may be because of the pattern position, and for example, when you are investing multiple patterns, if you are investing at the same level, and then these areas will resist the expansion of the mold, which may definitely cause some of the irregularities. In order to avoid that, you should always invest the wax pattern at a different level. Apart from this, there are some other reasons, for example, like carbon inclusion, or the roughness is because you are again using the old metal to make another crown, or it may be because of improper pickling, or if your molten metal gets contaminated with mercury. Now let's talk about the most important and most commonly asked casting defect, that is the porosity. And what is the problem with the porosity? Porosity basically means that localized area is devoid of any metal, and this will reduce the strength of the cast restoration. Porosities can be external or internal. External porosities are mostly because of the surface irregularities, or it can be internal porosity, which is reaching the external surface too. Based on the reasons, the porosities are classified into three categories. First being the solidification shrinkage, the second being the absorbed gases, and the third being because of the air entrapment. So let's first discuss about the first type of porosity, and that is based on solidification shrinkage. And what does that mean? As discussed in the earlier videos of dental casting alloys, we know that the metals which are used to make cast restoration shrink around 1.25%. So if the porosity happens because of this metal shrinkage, then it belongs to this category of solidification shrinkage. And there are two types of porosity which are based on solidification shrinkage. The first being the localized shrinkage porosity, and the second being the microporosity. And let us learn how they develop. So first is the localized shrinkage porosity, and please note that this develops internally, meaning you have to cut through the casting, only then you will be able to see it. So let's learn how it forms. The arrow here indicates the mold space which is formed by the wax pattern of the cast restoration. And this arrow indicates the space created by the sprue. As we know that the metal will flow from the sprue and then it is reaching the other parts of the mold space of the cast restoration. And when the metal is reaching the extremities, it is getting cooled down. And while cooling, it is going to shrink. But this shrinkage will not be evident because when it is going to shrink, there is constant feeding of molten metal in this area. Hence, there is no shrinkage which is happening here. But the junction where the sprue and the pattern meet, this area is still hot because there is a constant amount of molten metal alloy which is reaching here, compared to all the other areas where the cooling is already happening and there is no shrinkage. Now, if the molten metal alloy stops coming from the sprue area, this area will start cooling down. But unfortunately, in this area, although the metal is trying to shrink, but the shrinkage will not be compensated with extra metal because the metal is not coming from the sprue junction. And that's why the shrinkage will happen here. And that shrinkage leads to a porosity called as localized shrinkage porosity. So how do you prevent it? We can do it by increasing the amount of metal which reaches the mold space. And that can be done by increasing the diameter of the sprue or decrease the length of the sprue, which both will increase the velocity of the metal in order to reach the mold space. We can also use a reservoir, and the reservoir basically has some extra amount of molten metal alloy. And as explained earlier, the junction between the sprue and the wax pattern This is the area which is going to shrink at the last moment. And while it is shrinking, the reservoir will make sure that the shrinkage is compensated with extra fluid metal, preventing the porosity from forming. You can also increase the metal melting temperature and the temperature of the mold, which will also reduce the localized shrinkage porosity. Till now, we learned that localized shrinkage porosity mostly happens at the junction of sprue and the wax pattern. But there is another variety of localized shrinkage porosity depending on the location, and that is called as hot spot porosity, or it is also called as suck back porosity. And this is seen externally. As you can see in this image, if the sprue is attached 90 degree to the wax pattern, the metal will directly come and hit the opposite side of the wall of the mold, and this area will form a hot spot. And as soon as the top portion starts cooling down and this becomes the last area to shrink, but there is no molten metal alloy at this junction to compensate for the shrinkage. And if you want to prevent the hot spot porosity, you have to make sure that the sprue is not attached 90 degree to the wax pattern and it is flared in direction at the thickest portion of the wax pattern. This will reduce the impact of molten metal alloy on the walls of the mold. The second type of solidification shrinkage porosity is named as microporosities, and as you can see in this SEM image, the metal is actually made up of grains, and in between these grains we have some amount of microvoid generally present. So when the metal is trying to shrink, it basically means that the metal grains are trying to come closer to each other, and if there is sufficient amount of time, these microvoids will come out of these areas and segregate at one portion. However, if the cooling happens very fast, there is no enough time, and these microvoids will get trapped between the metal grains, leading to formation of microporosities. And if you want to prevent it, that doesn't depend on how much metal is reaching the mold space. This depends on the temperature of the metal, and in order to prevent microporosities, you can increase the molten metal temperature or increase the mold temperature, which will give sufficient amount of time to microvoids to come out of the grain when the grains are coming closer to each other. So we finished the first category of porosity, that is solidification shrinkage. Now let us learn the second type of porosity, which is because of the absorbed gases. There are three types of porosities which are formed because of the absorbed gases. First being the pinhole, the second being the gas inclusion, and the third being the subsurface porosity. The gas inclusion and pinhole porosity are almost similar, except that the gas inclusion porosity are larger in shape. Let's learn about the pinhole porosity. The pinhole porosity is mostly because of the gases which are absorbed by the molten metal alloy rather than the gases which are present in the mold space. As we know that most of the dental casting alloys have copper and silver in them, and they have high affinity for oxygen, and this oxygen will get dissolved in this molten metal alloy, and when the molten metal alloy flows into the mold space and when it is cooling down, it will expel this gas on the top portion, making the pinhole porosity, as you can see in this image. This can also happen if you are not using a reducing flame to melt the molten metal alloy. Similarly, in gas inclusion, it is the gases which are present in the mold space which will get absorbed by the metal as the metal reaches mold space, and slowly it will start expelling this gas on the top portion, but the size of the porosity which is formed will be larger in size. The pinhole and gas inclusion porosity can happen more if you are using a already used metal alloy, because there is already contamination, and if you want to prevent it, you can use carbon crucible for gold alloys to absorb these gases or impurities, and you can use the reducing flame which reduces the oxygen. The third type of porosity because of the absorbed gases is called as subsurface porosity, and in subsurface porosity you have molten metal alloy with absorbed gases into the mold, but initially they are not in contact with the mold surface, but as soon as the outermost molten metal alloy comes in contact with the external surface, and if the cooling happens suddenly, then there is no time for escape of the absorbed gases. And that's why, even though these porosities are because of absorbed gases, but since the metal is not able to expel it outside, the absorbed gases develop porosities internally, in contrast to the pinhole or microporosity. The last type of porosity is because of air entrapment, and it is generally called as back pressure porosity. Whenever the metal is entering entering from the sprue area, the air in the mold should escape from the investment material because of its porous nature. But in some local areas, we'll have some amount of air pockets which can prevent the metal from reaching this junction. In order to prevent this, one had to make sure that the distance between the tip of pattern and at the end of the ring should not be less than 6.5 mm, which will make sure that there is no resistance for the outward movement of the air from the mold. Now let's talk about the last, that is the fourth category of the casting defect, and it's called as incomplete casting, which is different from other defects because here you may not find the complete casting or a whole part of the casting is missing. And this is generally because the metal is not able to flow inside the mold, and there can be two reasons for it. And the first is the presence of a wax residue because of improper burnout. Now when the hot molten metal enters the mold space and hits this wax residue, this is suddenly going to burst because of the combustion and release the carbon monoxide gas. And because of this gas, the molten metal will not be able to reach this area. And the incomplete casting because of this reason are easy to identify. They generally have a shiny surface compared to the normal surface, and that's because of high reducing property of the carbon monoxide gas. The second reason is because of the molten metal, and that may be because of its high viscosity or low density or insufficient pressure. For example, in our video of dental casting alloy, we realized that the class 4 casting alloys, which are base metal alloys, have a very low density. So they will not be able to enter the mold space very easily compared to the class 1, which is high density gold alloys. Also, it may be because of insufficient pressure, and the textbook says that even though the metal solidifies in 1 second, you still have to apply the pressure for minimum 4 seconds to make sure that the metal will reach the deeper portion completely. And these type of casting defects are identified by rounded margins on the casting, indicating that they are not able to reach the deeper narrow portion. I hope that you will also check the various playlists on dental materials, operative dentistry. If you like the video, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon.